Saka T, it's a privilege to have him with you. Welcome, Baba Landlord. How are you doing, sir?
I'm doing good, and we say good, and thank you for having me.
Yes, it's been a wonderful. We had a pre-interview, and it was awesome. So, how has the journey been since you started in the entertainment industry as an actor?
Well, I'll say I thank God. It hasn't been smooth, but I don't think there's any journey that has actually been smooth for anybody in this world. So, I thank God so far has gone.
Okay, he's really thanking God. But how did you see it? Because I also did a bit of research that you did banking and finance, and now you are acting. You've been there for a while. How did you switch from banking and finance to acting?
No, I did not switch because I never worked.
You never worked in the bank?
Yeah. I went to Unilag.
Yeah.
And there's this theater group called Theater 15 in Unilag. I was in Theater 15. And then from there, while Adenuga came, did audition for some of us, and some of us passed.
Wow.
And I started with Papa Jasko. So I never thought I would do TV.
Wow.
I just did theater for fun. But today, I thank God where I am.
That's why you have to follow your passion at every point in time. Okay, tell us now, what are the challenges you face so far as an actor in the Nigerian entertainment industry?
Well, most of the challenges is money.
Money? Okay.
Because sometimes we feel we don't get paid as much as they ought to. And then sometimes some people believe that the life you live on screen is actually your... The life you are supposed to live. Yeah. So it becomes a problem when the public is seen in a public place or something then. And it affects a lot of actors. Because a lot of actors, if their cars are fault or they don't have cars yet, they sometimes don't go out.
Wow.
Because the Nigerian mentality that an actor gets billions of naira.
Oh man, that means it's really challenging because your ability to live up to standard in the face of the public.
Man, I'm not living up to anybody's standard.
Okay, you have to understand.
Yes, because the truth about the matter is, I get paid for what I do.
Yeah.
I will not go and thief or steal. And I believe that wherever I am today, it's God.
God, yeah.
So if somebody's creates a standard for me, if you feel that you see me in Uber or in cab or in bus, and you feel that you don't like my status or where I am, then you can buy me a helicopter. Or buy me
Formatic
or anything.
Or a range.
I will appreciate it. So that is just you don't just stay in your own lane and now jump to somebody else's lane and say that the life that person is living is not worth
what it ought to be. So that means you just have to be yourself, even as a celebrity. How did the name Baba Landlord come about? How did that name come about?
The thing about it is that, like I said, I was in theater 15. Then at a particular time when we left school, Kaya Ode Peter started Twilight Zone.
Okay.
Then from there, I was in Twilight Zone. Then he later started Flatmates. Then he just thought of it and they brought me in as Baba Landlord.
Baba Landlord.
And Flat then was shown on STV.
STV, yeah.
Years back, before Mnet commissioned it.
Okay, yeah, and that Flatmate is really doing well. A whole lot of actors have been brought on board. Shout out to Bright Okocha, a.k.a. Basketmouth, man. Thumbs up to him. Now, let's see. How did you cope during this Corona, when the Corona was there, when entertainers couldn't even go out to do shows? How did you cope during that period?
Well, I thank God, though. As I always say, in everything, I'll thank God.
Yeah.
One, we're under, as you said, Bright and Carl D. Peters are our producers.
Sure.
I mean, executive producers.
Yeah, yeah.
And to the glory of God, in that COVID, in fact, they were paying us our salaries.
Wow.
Even being at home, they were paying us our salaries. So, I thank the Lord.
Wow, that means shout out to them and those that were able to still pay salaries. What has been your most challenging role so far in your journey?
I don't think I've had any really, really challenging role. You know, the only thing I had, I told somebody some other time was that, there was this executive producer that I worked with. You have to say his scripts word for word.
As if you are cramming.
No, you have to cram. Because if you don't, he will tell you are missing that line. No, not that line. You are missing that word.
That word, yeah.
I paid for that script. So because he paid for that, for the script, yeah, you have to do it word for word. But apart from that, I don't think there's anything really challenging, because this is what I do for a living. So I don't think there's any role. And then I think the other thing, the roles I do, I think I can play is, if I'm asked to play, maybe have an Igbo accent,
okay,
or a Calabar accent, I might have issues there. I think that's all.
Okay, but that means you are a bit versatile. Okay, looking at the industry now, if you were to change some things in the movie industry, what are those things you would change to make the industry better?
A lot of government policies in the industry.
Okay.
At least the involvement, financially, more of government financial involvement in the industry.
Yeah.
It's really killing. Then, the fee.
The fee.
A lot of things. Because, like, for example, now, you get paid, fine. You know, before Mnet came,
sure,
there was a lot of stress in the industry.
Wow.
Mnet came and really helped. I would not say it in another tone.
Shout out to Mnet.
They really helped in the industry.
Yeah.
But the truth about the matter is the pay is still low compared to what people expect from you outside.
From you, yeah.
So the pay is still really, really low. Then the working environment.
Sure.
You saw what just happened before this interview started.
Yeah, sure.
Somebody walked up to us and said, I had to give him money.
Give him money,
because
right,
he's on my adubo. He lives in the area. So that's one of the problems we face.
Yeah. So we've seen it all on my adubo, all this, and there are major challenges. Okay, what are your plans? What are your future plans? Like, what are those things you intend doing, like, post-COVID and even now? Are you working on any project presently?
Well, there's a lot of projects, so...
Okay.
But as I said, you see the financial aspect of it, that it's constraining it. But there are a lot of projects. I tend to do a 10-minute web series.
Okay.
I'm planning that very soon I'll start.
Okay, very soon. So just keep your fingers crossed. Baba Landlord will be dropping a web series very, very soon. Looking at Nigeria now, if you are made the president of Nigeria, what are those three major things you will change?
Chai! If I'm made
president of Nigeria,
no, don't make me the president. Make me the military head of state.
Military?
Yeah.
No more civilian.
No more. Because one, I'll first wipe the Senate and reduce their. I will reduce their salary.
Hey, go break
out. I will make it to an extent that it will not be attractive.
Yeah.
So if you are not coming to serve, you can't be in the Senate.
Yeah.
You understand? Even the governors. Because these places are too juicy.
Yeah.
Thank them so much for loving me. And you know, it gives me joy when you walk on the street and someone says, Baba Landlord.
Yeah.
But you know, let them understand that they don't pay us millions.
Yeah.
So it is, because I told some people one day, there are about six or seven of them on the table. And their table was filled. That day I went for audition. No?
Yeah.
Their table was filled with drinks. They were drinking. And the next thing is, Baba Landlord, come and buy us drink. I said, two people ashamed. There are about 12 of you on the table. I don't take alcohol. So 12 of you cannot give me a bottle of malt. They said, okay, no worry. That, sit down, they'll buy me a bottle of malt. Then after they buy me a bottle of malt, I'll buy them a crate of beer.
Guy, trade by butter.
You can imagine. So let them just believe that it's not that we make
so much.
But we thank God, we too, we have family.
Yeah.
If everywhere I go to, I drop money, what would I give my
family?
And you know, the way education is in Nigeria.
Very expensive.
Everything, not just education now, everything
is
expensive.
Okay.
So let them understand, Obiko, Ejo, Mobebeni.
Man, it's been an exciting time with yours truly, Baba Landlord, and yours truly, Saka T. I must say, I've enjoyed every second of this interview. Man, till I come your way next time, you never can tell the celebrity we are bringing on board. Thank you so much, Baba Landlord. Thank you for having us. God bless you.
Thank you for giving me your time.
Yeah, thank you very much.